Okay, I'm gonna sit off to the side.
Hey, how are you, Abby? I see you. Can you see me? Awesome. All righty. Well, it's 5:30 on Tuesday. It's our regular dance class time. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. And when you see on the screen, you might see my face, and then sometimes you see other little girls' faces around there. That's just people joining. And I'm finding when I teach preschool, some kids only stay for a short amount of time and then they leave. And then even last week, you had to run and go to the restroom. That's totally fine. You don't even have to raise your hand and say, "Miss Debbie, I'm leaving." You can just go and come right back, okay? So did you have a good week? Yes, awesome. I'm glad. Well, I'm gonna put on our very familiar marching music, and we'll start with that, okay? All right, let's stand up to our feet. I've got my little house here today, but I'm gonna march in front of it, and let's pick up our knees. Quarter turn, march to your right. And quarter turn, march to the back. Quarter turn, march to your left. And back to the front. All right, and pausing, heels together in ballet first position. Toes close and open and close and open. They close. And open, and close, and open. Now tendus, point and close. Tendu, point and close. Beautiful. All right, my dancers know their tendus. I love it. Point and close, point and close. Now with arms on back, tendu, point and close. Point and close, point and close. Dégagé is when the feet leave the floor. So we tendu, and then the foot lifts off the floor, and that makes dégagé. Dégagé. Beautiful. Now lifting the arms to first, all the way to fifth, opening to second, and hands go back to your hips for passe retiré. Touch the knee, down, to the knee, and down. To the knee and down, to the knee. Lovely. To the knee and down, to the knee and down, to the knee and down, to the knee. Relevé. Heels go up and down, heels up and down, heels up and down, up and down, heels up. We're keeping our knees straight, but we're lifting the heels and pushing them forward so we stay in our turnout. Heels up and down, up and down, up and up and stay, stay, stay. Let's do tippy toe walks. Pushing one foot to the side, but never letting your heels drop. It takes really strong balance. And if you have trouble, you can hold your arms out to the side in a second. That helps our balance. Beautiful. Wow. Ballerinas way up there on dummy point without the heels touching the floor. That's amazing. All right, let's bring those heels back together and lower and back to parallel. And from the beginning, let's do arm marching. This time we're swinging our arms. And for a little rhythm practice, clap our hands. March and push our hands forward and back, front and back. And out to the side and in. Like we're pushing the walls away. Lovely. Can we push down? And we're still marching, so we've got a lot going on. We're moving our hands and our feet all together. You'll see the studio looks a little different today. I got out my ballet princess house. So inside my house, there might be things that are hiding. Last week, we we met her, it's her nap time. So I'm going to have her lay down inside the house. Bella Bear is here. She's been working hard. So I'm going to have her take a nap inside the house. The foot book, which is the story we looked at last week, we're going to look at pages again. I'm going to tuck that inside the house. And I'm going to have a seat. All right. So every week we change our theme just a little bit. I'm going to change the camera so you can see mine. So that's my little pretend house. Later, when the studio reopens for everybody to come in, it would be really fun if everybody wanted to crawl inside my little ballerina house, and we could play make-believe games in there. But for now, I'm just going to leave it here. The other thing that you'll see, oh, what does that sound like today? Shoes, that's right. Just to be silly, I'm going to put them on my hands. So when we do Pre-Dance Plus, we do a little ballet, a little tap, a little jazz, and hip-hop. Every week we review four dance forms. So today I actually brought the shoes along because for any of my students that normally do Pre-Dance Plus, by the time you're done with this school year, which is coming up, we've only got one more month, you're going to be ready to sign up for your regular tap class with Miss Savannah. So what I'd like you to do, I'll put this close to the screen. Okay, if someone goes to Reflection School of Dance website, they can also find that card, but there's an online shopping store where you can buy tights and leotards and sweatshirts and things like that. But for the girls who need their tap shoes, you'll buy it there, okay? So there's a code, it's 5678 time, but that's all on the website. So you can kind of let moms and dads know about that. It's not a rush, but if you just want to, you got some extra time because we're not in school right now, we can order our shoes. You could be doing your shoes, your tap class with your shoes next summer or in September. So pretty exciting, okay? Now I'm gonna switch over to our rhythm dance. We always do clapping and flapping, but for fun, I'm gonna stick my tap shoes on my hands when the time comes. And I'm gonna do all kinds of funny tapping with my shoes on, okay? So let's see how it goes. All right, let's warm up our hands. And. And floor, shoulders, floor, shoulders, floor, shoulders. Now, head, sky, head, sky, head, sky. Elbow, change. One, two, change. Elbows. Now, just to be silly, I'm going to take my tap shoes and I'm going to get them ready. So you're going to pretend that you have tap shoes on your hands. So show me your hands. There we go. Together, apart, together, apart, together, apart. Together, apart. Now we're going to go down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up. And girls can mirror me with your hands. Okay, I'm going to change the rhythm. We'll go hands together or shoes together for two. One, two. Then I'm going to go shoulder, shoulder. And it's going to look really silly because that looks like my feet, but they're really my hands. Okay, ready? One, two. Shoulder, shoulder. Floor, floor. Shoulder, then together. Shoulder, shoulder. Shoulder, shoulder. Shoulder, shoulder. Shoulder, shoulder. shoulder. Shoulder, shoulder. Shoulder, shoulder. New rhythm. Now we're going to go two on the floor, two together, two in the sky. Ready? Floor, floor. Together, together. Sky, sky. Floor, floor. Together, together. Sky and sky. And we could stay right there because the music stopped. All righty. Well, wonderful job with rhythms. So that's just kind of a fun way we can start introducing those tap shoes. And hopefully we have time to get those ordered anytime in the next few months is just great. But I don't know how many students have been maybe just sitting home, you're doing crafts and that kind of thing. Hopefully you got a chance to go outside because the sun is absolutely beautiful out there right now. But if we're not used to going to dance class, it's easy to maybe not always stretch the way that we should. So let's put on our music and do our stretching time. We're going to begin in crisscross applesauce. All right, we remember that one? Tuck those feet underneath, sitting tall, and head circle. New direction, head circle. Chins up, fingertips on our shoulders. Let's draw giant circles with our elbows. And backward, giant circles with the elbows. You feel that across your back and you feel it in your shoulders. All right, one hand down. Big reach to the side. And changing. Other hand down. Big reach to the side. And center. And put your hands out in front of you and walk them out as far as you can. Your head's going to come down close to the floor. And walk yourself back up again. And one more, walking out till your head touches the floor. And walk back up. Awesome. From crisscross applesauce, let's open our legs into straddle, second position. And when Miss Olivia teaches you, I says, surprise, show me your biggest straddle. Beautiful, toes are pointed, legs are straight. Reach side, bringing your ear down to your knee. And center, arms to fifth. Other side, bringing your ear to your knee. And center, arms to fifth. Beautiful. Side, ear to the knee. And come center, arms to fifth. Side, ear to your knee. And center, arms to fifth. Beautiful. Last time, ear to the knee and center, arms to fifth. Last time, other side. Ear to the knee and center, arms to fifth. Now let's do second and first and fifth and second and first and fifth. And second. Now this one's a little tricky. A lot of my preschoolers don't know third position. Curve one and keep one straight. Overhead, curve one and keep one straight. And then bring it back to second. Let's try the other arm now. Curve the other one. This is your third position. Curve one, one straight. Then take it up over your head. Beautiful. Oh my goodness, what lovely ballet we're doing. Back to second. Okay, ready? First arm in and up and to second. Other arm in and up and to second. Now both arms in and up and to second. Awesome. Good, good, good. Let's go ahead and stretch our legs a little bit more. Hands on the floor in front of you and put your elbows down. And if you can, you're gonna walk your elbows out just a little farther so you get a bigger straddle stretch. And a little farther again. And a little farther until your nose touches the floor. And back up we go. Awesome, beautiful stretching for your second position. Alrighty, Well, if you have a chair or something you can hold on to, we're going to do our ballet bar work. So I'm going to grab my chair. All right. And I have to move my little princess house out of the way to make room for my ballet bar. Okay? All righty. So, really, you can use anything in your house. You can use a coffee table, or if there's no furniture, you can just stand with your hands on your hips, and steps are just the same, okay? So, actually, why don't I do that? Because it looks like, yeah, don't worry about looking around to try to find something. I'm going to change the angle on the camera, and my hips will become my ballet bar for today, okay? So, you'll see me just like that. Feel like I can't see my feet, okay? Okay, our tendus. We're going to do demi point, full point, demi, close. Other foot. Demi, point, demi, close. Demi, point, demi, close. Demi, point, demi, close. Demi, point, demi, close. Demi, point. Demi, close. Now we've been going side to side, which is called à la seconde. Now I'm going to go devant, which is to the front. Ready? Front. Demi, point. Demi, close first. 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 Demi, point. Demi, close. Demi, point. Demi, close. Demi, point. Demi, close. Demi, point. Demi, and close. Good. Now, because our Zoom classroom is very short, I'm going to go quickly. So we're going to go right into rond de jambe. That's when we stir up our paint, pour the paint onto the floor, dip your toes in, and get ready to paint those rainbows. One leg goes around the other one. To the front, paint to the side, around to the back, close in first. Other foot, front, around to the side, around to the back, close in first. To the front, to the side, to the back, close in first. Other foot, front, to the side, to the back, close in first. Now this is going to be really good for our balancing. We're going to scoop our bowls up, pretend you're holding your princess paint, and keep paint holding it while you paint. Ready? Front, side, back, and close. 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 All right, you can pour your paint out. If you did the rond de jambes and you didn't pour any paint on the floor because you're balancing really well, then that's fantastic. So you have to kind of pat yourself on the back and say, good balancing. You held the paint and we did rond de jambes without dropping it. Okay, we only have one more ballet bar exercise today. It is the PKs. So if you poured your paint on the floor, go ahead and dip your toes into the paint. It's time for polka dots. We're going to do four dots to the front, four to the side, four to the back, and then hold in first position. Okay, ready? Polka dots. One, two, three, four. Side, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Closing in first. Other foot. One, two, three, four. Side, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. And close in first. And finish. Yay! Wonderful. Well, we did a wonderful job on our ballet bar work today. And I'm going to bring my princess house over. And I need to see what's inside the house. I think it is story time. The book was hiding inside my princess house.
Now, this is the same book that we had last week when we had our Tuesday class. It's Dr. Seuss's foot book. And this character is standing on one foot and balancing. That can be called a tilt. It can also be called a side arabesque. His ballet technique is actually not very good. However, he's a Dr. Seuss character, so that's okay. So throughout the book, last week when we did this, I said, okay, show me your feet. And different times when I was reading the story, all those feet would pop up on the screen because it's time to show our feet. But before we even get into the story, let's see if we can imitate the guy on the front of the book. So, I've got my chair. I'm gonna use definitely balance. So see the shape? He's kind of tilting. He's extending his leg up and he's holding it. Awesome. Now I notice he kind of has his hands in a kind of funny Dr. Seuss way. So let's take Dr. Seuss' hands. Oh, nice, okay. And Miss Debbie has her funny hairstyle today. She even looks like a Dr. Seuss character with her funny hair. Mm-hmm. Okay, so here we go. Dr. Seuss arms, extend that leg up. Show me those feet. Awesome. Alrighty, so we're ready for the story. The Foot Book by Dr. Seuss. The Foot Book. Left foot, left foot, right. Feet in the morning, feet at night. Left foot, left foot, right. Wet foot, dry foot, low foot, high foot. Front foot, back foot, feet, feet, feet. Red foot, black foot. Left foot, right foot, feet, feet, feet. Oh, how many, many feet you meet. Slow feet, quick feet, trick feet, sick feet. This one's very sad. His feet are sick and he had to wrap them up in bandages so they'll feel better. Up feet, down feet, here come clown feet. Small feet, big feet, here come pig feet. Does anybody have a pig in their house? Probably not. There might be some people who live on a farm, but mostly around Reflection School of Dance, people live in town. His feet, her feet, fuzzy fur feet. So we have boys have feet, girls have feet, but crazy furry animals like dogs and cats also have feet. In the house and on the street. How many, many feet you meet. Up in the air feet, over the chair feet. I think we should try that one. If you have a chair or a stool, could you climb all the way up over the top of it? Let's give it a try. So I've got my chair. What if I stepped on the chair and over the chair and came off on the other side? There's stools and rocks, or if we were out in the yard, you might have playground equipment. There's lots of things we could climb on. And this funny character is leaping so high, doing his grand jeté, that he's going flying up, up, over the chair. Beautiful. He's up on top. More and more feet, 24 feet. Those are some funny Dr. Seuss characters. Most people only have 2 feet, but these characters have many, many, many feet.
And animals have 4 feet.
Some have 4. Can you think of one that has 8?
No.
Yeah, they're not really feet, they're tentacles, but an octopus has 8.
No.
Left foot. What's that?
Arthropods.
So there's so many things that have feet. Even sometimes tables have feet. They have legs, and then they have little feet at the bottom to hold them up. Left foot, right foot, feet, feet, feet. Oh, how many feet you meet. When we come to ballet class, it's all about the feet. We're always doing things, marching, skipping, doing our tendus, getting our feet all ready. And we're gonna need our feet on today to practice our recital dance. Do you remember the name of your recital dance?
No, I forgot.
It's called Hip Hop Around the Clock, because our theme of our show this year is time. We look at the clock a lot. This clock says it's 5 minutes to six. But in our Hip Hop Around the Clock, he calls out a lot of different times. So whenever you hear the time, if he says it's 1 o'clock, you just put one finger up. And we put up enough fingers to help ourselves remember. But since we only have 10 fingers, but there's 12 numbers on a clock, if he says it's 12 o'clock, we have to go 10 plus two. Okay? So I'm gonna move my chair out of the way and move my princess house out of the way so we have space to practice our recital dance, hip hop around the clock.
My birthday is soon.
It's soon? Are you gonna be 6 years old?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, it's gonna be a very special birthday.
April 27th.
You're gonna be seven?
No, it's April 27th.
April 27th. That is coming because we're in the month of April right now. I'm excited for you.
And also my dad's birthday is tomorrow.
Did you make him a cupcake yet?
No.
Maybe when dance class is over, you'll have time to make him a cupcake.
Or make him a card.
Or you could perform your recital dance for him. That could be cool.
I want to keep this surprise.
Oh, we're going to keep that a surprise. Okay, sounds good. All right, so let's give it a try. Feet apart in second position. Feet are parallel, not turned out. So the toes and heels in the same direction. Our arms are folded because we're B-girls. And we just kind of nod our head like, mm-hmm, I'm looking cool. I'm a dancer, okay? And then we say, hip hop around the clock. Remember that move. And when he says a certain time, he might say 7 o'clock, so we do our seven, and then with the heads we go tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, and then we scoop hip hop, punch the clock around the clock. Okay? So those are all moves we know. The only thing that's a little different when we get to the very end, it says hip hop around the clock, hip hop around the clock, and on the third one, hip hop around the clock, the arms go punch, 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 and open. So it goes tick, tock, tick, tock, tock. And you remember how we have to balance on one leg? Just like the Dr. Seuss character was doing today, he was balancing on one leg. When we do our clock dance, same thing. Here we go.
Say the time you stop. If you're at the time, you say
hip hop around the clock.
Hip hop around the clock. Hip hop around the clock. Now the time is 8 o'clock. Thank you. hop, a round hop. Now the time is 7 o'clock.
Tuesday 5:30, know their recital dance really, really well. The only thing we have to remember is at the very end it's different because he says hip hop around the clock. He says it three times instead of two. And on the third one is when we go punch, 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 tick tock. Okay? You are right on time. You've got it. So I think we are going to be all set. Now I do have exciting news because the recital costumes are starting to arrive at the studio. So even though our doors are closed right now, what will happen is all the kids are going to get an email and we'll do something called curbside pickup. And you can come to the studio and we'll make sure the costumes are ready and we'll just bring them out to the cars. And that'll be in a couple of weeks, right before we hopefully if everything goes well, reopen our doors. But we definitely have your costumes and we'll get that out to you. So that's going to be super fun. Now we've got a few more minutes. So we've already done our ballet bar work. We did our rhythm with the tap shoes on our hands or just hands, but we haven't done our tap section with our feet yet. So just like the foot book of Dr. Seuss, we got to get those feet on and follow me for our tap section with our feet. Okay, standing tall, hands on your hips. And right foot forward. Toes and tap. Change feet, tap left. Thank you.
finish. Yay! Great job on the tap section. That song is called All That Jazz, and I'll be really excited when the girls get their tap shoes that make lots of noise. Alrighty, our second tap dance for today is called Hit the Road Jack. Pigeon toe is a tap step that we have worked on before. You have 1 foot forward and 1 foot back. Then you pick up your toe and you go in and out and in and out. And the heel stays down on the floor, okay? So we're gonna try that with both feet. This one is my right foot. For you, it's gonna feel like your left foot because I'm sort of inside the mirror from you. And then other foot, your heel is down, the toe is up, and you take the toe in and out and in and out. Okay, so with our song called Hit the Road Jack, we're gonna practice our pigeon toe step. Okay, right foot front, toes in, out, in, out, in, out, in, step change, and in, out, in, out, in, out, in, step change, toes go in, out, in, we work on our tendus and our plies. Each week we do a little tap. We did tap with our hands when Miss Debbie put the tap shoes on her hands earlier, and then we just did those two songs. We did a little hip hop because our recital dance is hip hop. So if mom or dad might say, what's your dance you're working on? It's called Hip Hop Around the Clock. Our last one, we need to do a little jazz. Jazz is when we, our warm-up is when we move one part of our body at a time. So I'll put our jazz song on and then I'll step away from the camera so you can see me. We start at the top of our heads, work all the way down our body, and then I might call out two things at once. I might say hands and toes or head and shoulders or something like that. So let's give it a try. Okay, we're gonna get to your feet apart. Hands behind your back. Start with just your head and nod your head. Look side center, side center.
Shove up and wipe. This one for the good girls and good girls. They have to be
Change direction, new circle. Shoulders.
Girls, it's your hallelujah.
Okay, so that's the way we say thank you in ballet class. It's a nice slow movement to help our bodies to kind of slow back down after we've been doing all the hard work of being in dance class. All right, let's stand in first position, arms to first, up to fifth. To second, one foot front, side, back and curtsy. Thank you to the teacher. Again, arms first, fifth, and slowly open to second. Hold right there, other foot to the front, to the side, to the back curtsy. Thank you to the dancers for joining today. One more, arms first. Up to fifth, open to second, hold right there. One foot front, side, to the back and curtsy. And thank you to God for healthy bodies, and give yourself the hand, girl. Alrighty, we are done with Pre-Dance Plus for today. Awesome participation. So good to have you today. We're going to close class out. If you want to join us back in a few minutes, we're going to start a musical theater class with the older kids. But younger ones, you're done for today. So happy to see you. I'll see you again next Tuesday. If you want to join Saturday, we do have a preschool class Saturday morning also. So see you soon. Enjoy the sunshine. God bless you.
Bye.